Herzlich willkommen bei DOPAG.
Welcome to DOPAG. Today, we will show you how to handle the initial commissioning and how to change the drum for a 200-liter adhesive drum pump. It is equipped with two-hand control and a drum roll-in mechanism, as well as a module for external controlling. The video will show you in detail how all of this works and will explain the benefits. Let's begin with the commissioning. First, we will loosen the drum centerings and push them outwards to make space for the container. Then we move straight on to the control unit. The intuitive two-hand control is designed very simple. All controls for the lifter are on the left-hand side, and all controls for the feed pump are on the right-hand side. The standby display and the reset button for the empty alarm are located in the center. Before the system is supplied with compressed air, it is important to close the regulators for lifter and pump pressure and set the selector switch to down. We now connect the compressed air via the air maintenance unit and set the lifter pressure using the regulator. We recommend a maximum of 2 bar here in order to prevent any sudden movements. As soon as the lifter is pressurized, we set the selector switch to up. Via upwards button, we move the lifter up. Next, we bring in the follower plate. The container is first placed in the center. The drum roll-in mechanism helps us to do this without having to apply a lot of force. We recommend applying Vaseline to the dry follower plate before inserting it. Using two hands, we then position the follower plate about 1 centimeter in front of the container edge and align the container to the center beneath the follower plate. Once this position is found, we fix it in place via drum centerings. Finally, we unscrew the derring rod. Next, we place a cloth around the derring rod. Using two hands, we move the follower plate slowly into the container. The air material mix is channeled out through the derring rod by the buildup of contact pressure. Once there are no more air pockets in the material, we close the derring rod and remove the cloth. The follower plate has been fully dared, so now we turn to the feed pump. We turn the drive on using the rotary switch and then open the derring ball valve. The derring begins as soon as the drive pressure is turned up via the pressure regulator. Once there are no more air pockets in the material, we close the derring ball valve again. Finally, we tighten the stuffing box nut of the feed pump using the tool provided. The pump is now ready to use. If we now wanted to integrate the pump into a higher level system, there are various external connection options available. The pump can be connected to a master control system via a multiple plug. Depending on the expansion stage, the level control signals and an on-off signal from the feed pump can be monitored externally. If the pump is to be controlled in addition to monitoring, there is a module available to start and stop the pump externally and to open and close the supply air pressure. In the second part of the video, we will explain the process of changing the drum for the adhesive drum pump with two-hand control. If the container is empty, the level control switches off the feed pump, and the empty signal is passed on to the master control system. This means that the container needs to be changed. First, we turn off the pump using the rotary switch. Then, we open the throttle for the follower plate airing. This directs compressed air via the check valve on the follower plate and supports it to move out of the container. Next, we move the selector switch up, which brings the follower plate out of the container slowly. To speed up the process, we can also press the up button. To extend it fully out of the container, we close the throttle again for airing. We then fully extend the pump lever using the up button until it reaches the highest position. To change the container, we loosen the drum centerings and remove the empty container. It is recommended to remove any material residues from the follower plate using a cloth. The follower plate can be lubricated with some Vaseline to ensure that it retracts properly into the new container. We then place the new container in the center beneath the follower plate and fix the centerings. Before we insert the follower plate back into the container, we open the dairing rod 2 revolutions and place a cleaning cloth. Next, we move the follower plate onto the material surface using the 2-hand control. The air material mix is channeled out through the dairing rod by the contact pressure. We press the 2-hand control until the ready signal on the pump appears and there are no more air pockets coming from the dairing rod. We can then close the dairing rod again and remove the cloth. The drum change is now completed and the pump is ready to use. I hope you're now all set to get your drum pump up and running. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact the DOPAG team. See you soon.